Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here. And most importantly, welcome to our new home, Slover Library. We are so glad you are here, and we are so glad to be back in our beautiful new home and back downtown again. My name is Bill Inge, and I'm with the Sargent Memorial Collection here at the library. And my specialty is building and architectural history. And I was asked to present a program on a history of the Slover Library site. Now, the Slover Library is actually made up of three buildings. We have the historic 1900 Federal Courthouse and Post Office Building, which also was City Hall, and then the brand new Slover Tower, and then the Selden Arcade, which was completed in 1931, incorporating the walls of the original Academy of Music Theater, which was built in 1880. So what this is going to be is a photographic presentation of all the buildings that used to be here, some maps and diagrams, and we're going to go way back to 1802 to get started. This is one of the earliest maps of Norfolk, the George Nicholson map from 1802. This is actually a reproduction from 1931. We have Granby Street right here, and this is Town Back Creek, and all of this right here is present-day City Hall Avenue. Catherine Street, that is now Bank Street. Here we have Main Street. So basically where the Slover Library site is all right in here, a good part of it being underwater. Now here's a later map from 1851. We have Granby Street right here. This is still Town Back Creek. There was a stone bridge here that I'll show you in the next photograph. Here's Plume Street, but as you can see, Plume Street did not go all the way across. Main Street is here. Concord Lane is still here, but will be very soon closed off where the new hotel is going up. Martin's Lane no longer exists. And then we have a street here called Dodd's Lane. And Dodd's Lane was named after John Dodd, who was an Irish immigrant, came to Norfolk, and lived to be 90 years old, owned a great deal of real estate in Norfolk, and owned all the property where the new Slover Library is today. And he had houses and buildings built on both sides of this street. Now, Gray Street, that is now Atlantic Street, and it was changed to Atlantic Street after the first Atlantic Hotel was built on that corner in 1867. Now, if people wonder why downtown Norfolk floods so much, this is why. This is an 1868 view of the intersection of Granby and City Hall Avenue. This is the old stone bridge at Granby and City Hall, which was completed in 1819. The present-day Royster Building would be right about here. This is looking west to Portsmouth. City Hall Avenue here. This house right here was the Cincinnatus Newton home that was completed in 1849. Thomas Eustick Walter, who designed the building that's now the MacArthur Memorial and the old Norfolk Academy, was the architect for this house. It was one of the finest homes in the city in its day. It was demolished in 1904, and it's where the law building on the corner of Granby and Plume sits today. An 1887 Sanborn map. For those who are not familiar, a Sanborn map is a fire insurance map. They were done all over the United States. They are one of the best sources for doing any type of research. Granby Street is here. We have Dodd's Lane here and Atlantic Street. A wagon shop on the site of the present-day Seaboard Building. And all these old tenement houses right here where the present-day Slover Library and the Selden Arcade sits. Now this building right here was Van Wyck's Academy of Music, completed in 1880 at a cost of $171,000. It seated 1,600 people, and in its day it was one of the finest theaters south of Washington, D.C. Van Wyck did not build the building. He leased the land from the Selden estate. And Dr. William B. Selden had purchased this land in December of 1843. He died in 1855 during the yellow fever outbreak. And the Selden and Grandy families continued ownership of this property way up through the 20th century. This was a very large building. It was the front was three stories with offices and the gallery and stage in the back. But note, we still have all these homes back here and a lot of homes here. Concord Lane was still pretty much residential as well. And here's an engraving from about 1890 of the Academy of Music. John Nernsey, who was a prominent architect in Baltimore, designed this building. He also did an opera house in Lynchburg as well. And the contractor for the building was James H. Calrow, and his name will come up again later. All right, and this is the entrance to the Academy of Music from 1915. This is a photograph taken by legendary photographer Harry C. Mann. All right, this is another Sanborn map from 1898, and this is an original book that we have in our collection. And if you notice, it's all color coordinated. The yellow represents frame buildings. The pink is for masonry. S is for store, D is for dwelling. We still have all the dwellings here. Dodds Lane, we now have a commercial building that has been built, and it was the home for the Norfolk, Virginia newspaper, which was the predecessor of the Virginian Pilot. Now the building, our Seaboard building that we're in now, was completed in 1900, and it was the United States Courthouse and Post Office. But like so many other federal buildings during that time period, there was a competition among architects to see who could turn out the winning design. And this was one of the proposals done by the Norfolk firm of Carpenter and Peebles. James Edwin Reuben Carpenter and John Cavan Peebles. Carpenter later went to New York City and became an accomplished architect of apartment buildings. Peebles has been referred to as the Dean of Norfolk Architects. This was actually a pretty interesting design that they submitted. And another one was submitted by a well-known Richmond firm of Nolan and Baskerville. In my opinion, I think this is not a very successful drawing. It just looks a little too heavy-handed. The winning design came again from Baltimore and the firm of Wyatt and Nolting, who had designed the City Hall building in Baltimore. They also designed the Virginia Bank and Trust Building, which is still standing. It's at the corner of Granby and Main, which is now the Virginia Club Building. And they also designed a home on Freemason Street for Dr. Grandy, and that is also still standing. These three drawings, by the way, all came from a periodical called American Architect and Building News, and we were able to get copies of the originals for the Sargent Memorial Collection. And here's a view of the completed building from 1905. This is a photograph from the Library of Congress. And then I think this is the classic early photograph of our building, taken about 1908 by Harry C. Mann. They had actually started construction on this building in January of 1899. It was built for almost $175,000 minus the heating system. And the heating system was an additional $12,000, but back then they didn't have to worry about air conditioning, so this was just for a hot water radiator system. And when they started building this building, they ran into a few problems. First of all, the ground was still marshy, so they had a lot of fill to do. And then they uncovered three graves that apparently had been used as a makeshift cemetery at some point. Now, some early postcard views of our building. The shell border postcard was very popular on a lot of different early Norfolk buildings. These are all probably from about 1910, 1915 vintage. And this is in between our building and the present day Slover when it was the post office in 1913. This is what our mail carrier's vehicles looked like. And from a publication called Artwork of Norfolk in 1902, a view of our building right here, and this is the building that the Dodd estate owned that was the home of the Norfolk Virginian. Yeah, that building is on City Hall Avenue. That was torn down about 30 or 35 years ago. It was later a hotel. It was right next to the Byrd Theater. And that's where that was a new building constructed for the Virginian Pilot in the early 1890s. and a postcard view from about 1905. This was easy to date because the law building, which was completed in 1905, is still under construction. Now, the Academy of Music, the back of the building is right here, but still you can see all the early homes that were behind it where the present-day Slover is. That's the Virginia Club building that's still standing. And these are the backs of the buildings on Granby Street in the 100 block that are still standing as well.
So the law building, is that where Norfolk Redevelopment is?
They're in, redevelopment is in the Royster building. The law building is undergoing renovations right now, and it's going to be apartments. All right, another Sanborn view. This is from 1910. And if you notice all the stores in the front, what they did, they took the existing dwellings and put storefronts, added storefronts to them in 1902. And the Dodd Estate, as you can see, Dodd's Lane is gone. Our building is here. And we have a new building here that was the Seaboard Fire Insurance Building. Which has an interesting story. Now, John Dodd had passed away, and his daughter, Eliza, inherited the property. She leased the land to the Seaboard Fire Insurance Company for $800 a year, and the insurance company, which John L. Roper was the president, built the new building in 1906 for a cost of $11,500, and they had their offices in the building, and they also rented the rest of it out for other insurance companies. So they were making money on this operation. And they also built the small frame building in the back as a bicycle repair shop. Now, I don't know how much they rented it for, but we have the building permit for the bicycle shop, and it cost $125 to build. This is, I think, my all-time favorite panorama shot of Norfolk, taken by Harry C. Mann about 1915. Here's the Academy of Music. This was a huge building, as you can tell. The old Citizens Bank of Norfolk, which is still standing. The new hotel is going up right in here. The old Atlantic Hotel there. You still have the dwellings here with the storefronts in front of them. And by then, the Royster building had been constructed. The Slover Library would be right in here, and this part here has all been replaced by the Selden Arcade, and then Selden filled in that part. So the Slover would be right about here. Now this is what Plume Street looked like in 1921. The Seaboard Fire Insurance Building was here, and we have one new building here, the Guarantee Title and Trust Corporation, which was built in 1920. Peebles and Ferguson were the architects for that building. This was a large real estate mortgage company, and we have all of their title abstracts and plats. It's about 2,500 title abstracts and about the same number of plats that we have in our collection. This building was later the Dean Building and then finally the Decker Building, and it was demolished for the new hotel. The facade has been saved and will be reassembled on the new hotel site. So the Selden Arcade actually takes up this part right here, and then the Slover Library site right here. And these were the new storefronts that were added in 1902 on the back in front of the existing homes. And a wonderful aerial shot of downtown from 1922. And here is all of the present day Academy of Music. The Guarantee Title building is right there. The Seaboard Fire Insurance building there. And then our building is right there. Now later I'm talking about our building when it was City Hall. And I've had some questions. Well, where did City Hall move to when they moved in our building in 1937? They moved from this building here, which was built in 1891 as a city armory and was later City Hall. And this building right here, famous Monticello Hotel. And a view from 1926. You can see the Academy is getting a little ratty, showing its age. These homes aren't doing too well either. The new guaranteed title and trust building. And this was a view taken in about 1929, right before the Academy of Music, which is right here, burned. And then a Sanborn map from 1928. A lot of the homes that had originally been back here are gone. We've got more new construction going on. And there was also an addition at some point made to the existing post office building. And we still have our bicycle repair shop, so business must have been good. Then on the Academy of Music had closed in the late 20s. This was one of the premier stage theaters in Norfolk and then became a legitimate motion picture theater. But with the construction of the Norva and the Lowe's State Theaters, its fortunes declined. It closed in the late 20s, and then on April 4th, 1930, it was destroyed by fire. And these photographs were taken by Charles Borges of the Virginian Pilot. And we have all of the Virginian Pilot and Ledger Dispatch, Ledger Star photo archives that are 1955 and older. And they never figured out what the cause was. But the Grandy family did not waste any time. The fire, like I said, was in April. In September, they drew up plans to replace this building with the Selden Arcade. And there are portions of this building that are still standing. The exterior walls and the section fronting on Main Street is all that's left. All the back portion on Plume Street is new from 1930-31. They started construction in September. Calrow Brown and Fitzgibbon were the architects, and that was James Calrow's stepson, Charles J. Calrow, who was also an accomplished architect here. The entire Selden Arcade was finished in 8 months. It opened in April of 1931 with great fanfare at a cost of $200,000, which was a great deal of money during those Depression years. And here is the newly completed Selden Arcade in 1931. They had 22 stores in the arcade itself, and there were 5 stores on fronted on Main Street and 5 stores that fronted on Plume Street. This was a automobile show from 1932, and I didn't even think about it. Someone said the auto show is this week. And here is a brand new Chevrolet Roadster that you could buy for $649.
Wow. You probably have one.
Now back to our building. The post office and the U.S. courthouse were still using it up until about 1934. And that's when the new courthouse building at 600 Granby Street, which is now the Walter P. Hoffman Courthouse, was completed. And all the federal offices went in here. But this is a photograph from 1931, taken on the second floor where the Sargent Memorial Collection is now, with them weighing packages for Christmas. Now, the city had an opportunity to purchase the existing courthouse in 1937, and then the following year it opened as the new City Hall. And this is a photograph taken on New Year's Eve, 1938, after City Hall had moved in.
A lot of rubble on this.
They had recently torn down a hotel building that was on that corner there, and that's where the Hampton Road Sanitation Building was later built in the 50s. This is the engineering department at City Hall in 1938.
Come a long way.
It sure has.
Kind of grand, right?
All right, this is downtown Norfolk, an aerial view from 1948. Now, this is the brand new Selden Arcade. So what they did, what was originally a three-story building, was reduced to two-story. They used the side walls, but all of this back section is completely new. What was left of the old dwellings and the storefronts were torn down in 1930-31 when the present-day Selden was built. And then here's our building right here and the Seaboard Fire Insurance right there. Nothing new, paying fees at City Hall in 1951. And see, before the Selden Arcade was actually enclosed in, this is how it looked. You could walk right through it. This is taken from the Plume Street side in 1949. And the Main Street facade from 1950. That's the old National Bank of Commerce, which was later First and Merchants Bank, and it was imploded in the late 80s, I think about 1987, 88. All right, this is really the best picture we have of the Seaboard Fire Insurance Building on Plume Street and the Selden Arcade, and this was taken in 1949. Now, by 1953, City Hall was busting at the seams. They were running out of room. And they were looking to eventually build a new civic center downtown where all the courts and all the City Hall would be under one roof. But they knew this was still going to be a few years away, so they had to come up with something. So they went ahead and bought the Seaboard Fire Insurance Building and some property behind it. And they demolished it for a parking lot for the time being. And then the following year, they engaged T. David Fitzgibbon, another prominent architect, who was with the Calro Brown and Fitzgibbon firm that had done the Selden Arcade, to design a City Hall annex building until the new City Hall complex was built. And they deliberately specified that when you build this building, make it so that when we leave it, we can sell it as an office building, which they did. And here is the new City Hall Annex. And here's our City Hall Annex, which was completed in, and this is what's so ironic. Now, the new Slover Library officially opened today, January 9th, 2015. The City Hall Annex opened on January 10th, 1955, almost 60 years to the day. And the entire cost, including architect's fees and contingencies, was $180,000. You have to remember, too, this was right at the beginning when Norfolk was undergoing revitalization. Everything that was old was out. They wanted things clean, sleek, and modern. No frills, none of this Victorian decoration. So Fitzgibbon delivered. He gave the city a modest, international-style building that suited the needs well. I think Commissioner of Revenue's office was in here, and when they demolished the building, their safe and vault was still in place. Here's another view of the annex with city officials out front. And then a view from 1959 showing the annex building and the Selden Arcade. In 1960, Norfolk got the All-American City Award, and they flew the flag out in front of the City Hall. Now, by the 1970s, the Selden Arcade was getting a little dated as well. The Art Deco style had gone out of fashion. So a new facade and new interior was given, and this is an architectural rendering of what it looked like in the 70s. I think what I really like about this are the cars. We have a Rolls Royce here and a Lincoln on the other side.
The rendering, very progressive.
Was that product placement?
Yes, I'm sure it was. And a Carol Walker photograph from 1982 after the building had been renovated. Now by then, the old Guarantee Title and Trust building, that had gone defunct in 1929 during the Depression. J. Frederick Dean, who was a lawyer, bought the building in the early 40s and converted it into an office building. And I think this picture was taken right before Pete Decker bought it and converted it into the Decker building. And when the existing Selden Arcade was remodeled in the late 70s, they also did the interior as well, gave it a more colonial appearance. And this is another Carol Walker picture. This is looking on Main Street. This is the Main Street garage, and stores are right here, and the Slover Library would be over there. And by the 2007, the High Page Company was occupying the former City Hall annex. Our building was occupied, as I said, by City Hall from 1938 to 1965 when they moved to the new City Hall building. Department of Social Services was there until the mid-70s, and then the building was sold. It was renovated in the 1980s by George Phillips of Henderson and Phillips Insurance, and it was used as insurance offices until the city purchased it back again. And it had been renamed the Seaboard Building. Norfolk Main Library was there for a few years and then moved out, and now this is all part of the Slover Library. Photograph when the High Page Building was demolished in 2010, and this officially started the new construction of the Slover Library. Some photographs, this was taken in 1982, the second floor of the Seaboard Building. Now, while today it is all carpeted, it was originally glass block laid in tiles on a steel frame. And a lot of that is still there. It has been covered over. Now, this is what it looked like in 1982 and 08. Troy Vowles took this photograph in 2013 with the new Slover Tower under construction. And our finished building today. This is the second floor of the Sargent Memorial Collection. You'll be able to go through from this building on the second and third floor to the Sargent Memorial. We're on the second and third floor of that building.